Hi! Today I'm going to tell you why you need good quality art supplies and give you 7 ways to find them. I want to talk about objective quality, that's whether a product is any good at all, and subjective quality, that's if it's good for what you personally are trying to do. So first, why do you need good quality products? Well, I've touched on this before, but they're pretty much essential if you want your work to last. Using good quality art supplies, both in the objective sense and in the subjective sense, will also ensure that you have the best experience possible and that you have the easiest time achieving your goals. Now for 7 ways to find good quality art supplies. Number 1, the little information blurbs about the product that you see on the company or the store's website that's selling it. Now this isn't a very good gauge for objective quality, just because it's not in either of these places' best interests to have you think that this product isn't worth buying, so they'll spin it in a positive way. But it can be a good gauge for subjective quality, because companies will often say whether a brand of paint is good, for example, for making heavy brush strokes or for glazing, or if a canvas is lightweight or heavyweight. Number 2, customer reviews. Some sites will post reviews from customers who have bought the product, although some sites might only post positive reviews, so kind of have to be careful with that one. Number 3 is vlogs and blogs. You can also find more in-depth reviews in the form of media such as these, run by other artists, many of whom aren't afraid to say if a product is lousy if that's the case. You can also see artists do entire projects using a particular brand of pencil or paint where they talk about it for a full 10 or 15 minutes, so you really get an idea of how good or not that product is. Many artists who make videos or blog, though, will probably be using products that suit them and their style, so it's probably best to look for an artist whose work looks how you would like yours to look. While we're on the topic of reviews, I know a lot of you might be thinking, these people are getting paid. But even if someone is being paid to promote a product, they still legally have to be honest about it, honest about their feelings. And many vloggers and bloggers believe in being honest ethically, because we know our viewers trust us. I mean, if I was reviewing a product, I will say what I think it's good for, or if I don't think it's good for something, or there's something I really don't like about it, I will say that. Number 4, real life friends and acquaintances. You could call or email artists you know in real life and ask them if they've used a product, and if they have, what they thought about it. Number 5 is art groups on Facebook or Google+, or any other site that has groups that I don't know about. Anyway, you have to join these groups first, but once you do, if you don't know any artists in real life who have used the product you're thinking of, you could write something on one of these groups like, I'm thinking of using such and such brand of paint, have any of you used it, what did you think of it, and people will probably respond. It would also help to specify what kind of look you're trying to achieve or what style you're painting in so that people know whether or not to recommend this product to you. Number 6 is the company's reputation. If a company has been around for a long time and has a solid reputation, you should be able to trust in the quality of their products. I'm talking about companies like Winsor & Newton, Derwin, General, Strathmore, pretty much any company that's instantly recognizable. Number 7, your own personal experience. This is the most important one above all the others. Everything else I mentioned can help, but the only way to know if you personally are going to like a product is to just buy it and try it. So that was why you need good quality art supplies and 7 ways to find them. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. I put out art videos 3 days a week, Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. So if that sounds good to you, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon to turn on notifications. For now, thanks for watching, and goodbye!